Hello. Coloured filters can be used to filter out certain wavelengths of light that land through a lens and onto a camera. Let's have a look a bit about colour theory to see how they work. You may know that different colours of light are actually different wavelengths of light, and a rainbow is when white light is split up into its constituent wavelengths by water. Your eye has three different cones, which are sensitive to different wavelengths of light. Now, they are sensitive to a range of wavelengths, but they peak at about these wavelengths. So those three color sensors can detect the whole spectrum of colors by depending on how much each of those three cones are firing. But they can also detect one more color that's not present in the rainbow. And that color is when the blue and the red cones fire together. You can form every color in the rainbow and this other color using red, green, and blue. And you can see those color mixing when you shine those three lights together. And white light is a combination of red, green, and blue. So all of those three together, your eye would see as white. The colour that's missing from the spectrum, you may notice, is this pinky purple colour called magenta. And that's because blue light is over here and red light is over here. So when blue and red cones fire in your eye, you see pink or magenta. So this is called primary colour mixing, these three colours. And computers and LCD screens can specify any colour by a combination of red, green, and blue intensity. And you might have seen things like this color picker, and this is from an app on a phone where you would choose a color. We've got green, red, and blue, and then having chosen where around on that towards the middle would be brighter, so more and more white, so you can change the brightness. Now, a filter is an ideal filter, only passes one specific wavelength, but in practice, filters can pass a band of different wavelengths. And you need to think about white light as being containing an equal amount of red, green, and blue to work out how filters operate. So, for example, this red filter, clearly white light shines in it, would pass red light. It filters out the other colors. And to think about that, I would consider a red filter with white light being red, green, and blue light landing on it, and the red filter only passes the red light. It absorbs, therefore, green and blue light. So what would happen if a red filter had yellow light shining on it? Well, remembering that color wheel, yellow is a combination of red and green light. So red would be able to be passed through the red filter. If you think about that in the way I showed before, yellow light is red and green, and red light can pass through the red filter, and so the resulting light through that filter would be red. So what would happen if cyan light were to hit a red filter? Well, no light would come through. And if you understand that in terms of the color theory, cyan light is blue and green, and a red filter only allows red light through. So neither the blue nor the green can pass through the red filter. And so, in theory, a red filter would completely block out cyan light, and no light would land on the film. How about a yellow filter with white light? Well, the yellow filter would allow the yellow light to pass through, but really it's not yellow light, it is a combination of two different colours. So white light is red, green, and blue, and yellow is red and green. So a yellow filter allows red and green to pass but absorbs blue. Now you can use that in photography. If you're taking photos of the sky, yellow or orange filters will absorb the blue light, and therefore no light will pass. If you're taking a black and white photo, or particularly with black and white film, then a yellow or orange filter will take out the blue light from the sky, and so it darkens the image or gives you a high contrast black and white photo with a dark sky. Digital post-production can now be used to perform similar effects by adjusting the red, green, and blue values in an image before then making it black and white. Colored objects appear in different colors because of the colors that they reflect or absorb. And to think about colored printing, you need to think about the colors that are absorbed. I'll show you why. So a red object absorbs the green and the blue light, and then they do not get reflected. But the red is reflected into your eye, and you see this object as looking red. Now, the absorbed colours are used in secondary colour printing. So coloured printing uses dots of cyan, magenta and yellow inks. So here is an exaggerated print photograph. And you can see that cyan, magenta and red are the three dots that have been making up this image. Cyan pigment absorbs red, but it reflects blue and green. Magenta pigments absorb green, and yellow pigments absorb blue light. So if we wanted this red object, we would print magenta and yellow ink dots. And you can see here around the lips that we've got some magenta and some yellow dots around here. And if you look from a distance or squint your eyes, that becomes red. And that's because the magenta is absorbing the green and the yellow is absorbing the blue. But both of those reflect the red. And so the red is overall reflected. And so this object, when viewed from a distance, appears red. Hope that helps.